Welcome to our latest version of Ask Me Anything. Today, we'll be focusing on everything you want to know about attending the Connected Planning Experience, or CPX for short. I am joined today by an amazing panel. We have an Anaplan customer and a couple of our own Anaplan employees who are here to answer questions that you may have. Slight programming change. Our partner won't be able to join us today, but he has answered our questions and will be posting them in the AMA group for you to take a look at. All right, let's go ahead and jump right in. Andrea, can you tell us about the evolution from Hub to CPX? Why the name change?
Sure, you know, we ask our customers and ourselves to embrace change all the time. This instance of change comes as no surprise post-IPO. We recognize and we embrace the opportunity to mature and evolve the Anaplan brand with our first big public event of the year. So goodbye Hub, hello Connected Planning Experience, or CPX. You know, the shift represents the evolution of a brand as we strive to ensure the experience isn't just a moment in time, rather something that we bring to life or generate excitement for in the weeks leading up to this June flagship event in San Francisco. But we also want to ensure that the excitement continues throughout the year as we plan for our traveling CPX events around the world in London, Paris, Singapore and Tokyo, all rebranded with this new CPX identity. You know, we're an international brand, so we strive to provide the same experiences, the same knowledge, the same scalable platform across the globe. So goodbye Hub, hello CPX.
Fantastic. I'm really excited to see how the change to focus on connected planning helps our attendees connect the dots. Pun intended. Speaking of our customers, Vicki, as a customer success director, what are the top three things that CPX offers to our customers? And what amazing things have you heard from our customers based on previous events?
Well, I would say that the top three things that our customers get by going to CPX are one, being able to see how other customers are using Anaplan. And so they'll be able to see presentations about their latest successes. You also get to see the product roadmap, which is exciting in itself. Part of the keynote is seeing where we're going with Anaplan. And then some of the sessions in the follow-on days are getting a more detailed view of what's to come in the product. And last but definitely not least is the networking. You get to talk with peers in your industries, peers that are in the same line of business as you, and you get to meet the people that you interact with at Anaplan and partners. So there's lots of networking and socialization going on, which is a lot of fun. Some of the amazing things that my customers shared having come from Hub, now CPX, is regardless of where they are in their customer journey, they're able to learn something about things from our customers, from partners. It could be something technical. It could be something about the product roadmap. They're just excited to learn. And it's a lot of the reasons that people go is the ability to have one-on-one conversations with other people that are doing like things. And that's something that the customer success team can set up for our customers at CPX. And the most exciting thing I hear is that they can't wait for the next one. So they're always looking for the next event.
That's fantastic. And I think you're right. Those are the things that I look forward to the most, really, is the networking and actually meeting the face behind the name. That's probably the biggest thing for me. I get to interact with a lot of folks as a product manager for community and super excited to see what the roadmap has to share. So we wouldn't have a CPX without our amazing customers. Sarah, so happy to have you with us today, not only as a customer, but a master Anaplanner. So you've attended Hub before in previous years. What do you look forward to most during this annual event?
Sure. So apart from everything Vicki just mentioned of it being just an awesome opportunity to network and to talk with peers, like she said, in our industry and even outside of our industry, just kind of learning what works for them. I think that the most beneficial takeaway that we had as a Groupon group when we were there was meeting with a fellow customer, Seagate, and they were able to walk through with us some of their solutions that they had implemented using Anaplan that were directly relevant to what we were trying to do with our project roadmap here at Groupon. And so not only is that inspirational, but it's extremely helpful for us because we are totally open to thinking outside of our own box. And I think that CPX really offers that opportunity to get to hear from other customers and not just successes. I mean, even kind of barriers or issues that they've come across and how they've solved them. That's also just been a huge benefit for us to learn from other people's, mistakes and then how they were able to make successes out of that.
I think that's a fantastic point because it's not just about the success, it's about what challenges have they come across and how have they solved for those challenges, right?
Challenges is a better word, not mistakes.
So Sarah, let's continue the conversation with you. What three pieces of advice would you give to customers attending CPX for the first time? And also, why is it worth it for master Anaplanners to attend?
Sure. So I guess right off the bat, I think it's super important to take a look at the agenda in which sessions are offered in advance of actually attending the conference. I had made that mistake myself of just kind of thinking I was going to wing it when I was there. And I really think that it makes sense, especially if you're going with a group of people, to kind of divide and conquer and identify which sessions seem to be the most relevant or the most interesting. And then not everyone going to the same one, you know, because kind of, I guess, my second item there is the opportunities to attend various topics while at CPX are unlimited, and it's super important to try to take away as much as you possibly can. And so by not only preparing in advance to decide which sessions you want to go to, but also by dividing and conquering among your team members, I think is kind of the best thing to do before you go or to plan to do. And then I'd also say attending as many of the networking events as well, just because, kind of like I'd mentioned before, one of the biggest benefits of going to CPX is getting to meet people that are doing very similar work to you. Whether or not it's the same use case for Anaplan is kind of irrelevant. It really is such a unique opportunity to be able to kind of hear from people and learn best practices that way. So I guess keeping an open mind and really an open schedule to be able to attend as many of the non-session events as possible. And as a master Anaplanner, I think that there are unlimited benefits to going to CPX because I'm not one to think that I know everything just because I was able to become a master Anaplanner. I mean, there's just so much to learn. And I think beyond just the technical pieces of Anaplan, going to CPX as a master Anaplanner is also an opportunity to learn strategically how Anaplan can be used. Yes, I'm sure I'll attend a technical session here and there, but really what I'm looking to get out of my experience at CPX this year is thinking more strategically about our project roadmap and how that aligns with Anaplan's project roadmap as well. And then being able to take back those, key takeaways to our end users here and communicating them effectively. Because a major initiative that we're working on at Groupon is training and change management. And so I think by going into CPX with more of a strategic lens in that regard is going to be hugely beneficial to us as a COE.
And Sarah, those are fantastic points, and I think it just resonates with the messaging around this being all about connected planning. So you're thinking about how to look at the project roadmap and be able to connect across the business to support, you know, kind of that end goal of connected planning in and of itself. So that's exactly. Fantastic. Awesome. Andrea, to that point, what insights or advice would you share with someone who is considering attending CPX, whether they're a customer or a prospect?
Stop thinking. Start doing, just register. You know, we've got a number of opportunities for you to experience the event at a discounted rate. So don't let cost deter you. We've got robust content in the form of keynote and breakout sessions, plus an expo hall full of hands-on learning experiences, and like Sarah mentioned, plenty of networking opportunities. So no doubt you'll walk away with the information that you need to justify the expense. So what will you take away? Information and prescriptive guidance on maximizing the value of of the Anaplan platform, a sneak peek into its latest features and capabilities. You'll form relationships from these networking events with others on the same connected planning journey as you. And you'll also gain connections with both Anaplan executives and sponsors alike. You just can't go wrong.
Absolutely. And I think it's interesting because, you know, Vicki has touched on this, Andrea, you've touched on this, and Sarah, you've certainly touched on this. But Vicki, as a customer success director, how do you use CPX to connect customers who are either at similar points in their journey or different points in their journey?
Well, I have to play off what Sarah said. It's all about making sure that you know what you want to see when you're at CPX. And what I do with my team and just anybody that's going to CPX is work to make sure that they've got a customized agenda or know what sessions would be good for them to attend so that they can get the most value out of their trip to CPX. So we make sure that we point out sessions that we think would be relevant for them and sessions that could be a potential stretch, but we see as being something that they could go see and think more strategically about Anaplan, playing off what Sarah mentioned as well. It's not just about the technical sessions. It could be more about learning about change management or just learning about how others have done things within their company. I work a lot to make sure that my customers are connected to people that they should get to meet, to other customers that they would be good to talk to. So getting them involved in the birds of a feather sessions where they're meeting with people in the same industry or doing the same use case or similar use case, those are really good ways to get connected. Setting up one-on-one sessions when I know that the customers want to meet each other. And just in general, when we're at the networking events, taking advantage of introducing people. I have the advantage of knowing a lot of people since I've worked with Anaplan for 5.5 years. So anytime I'm at a networking session, I always make a point to introduce people. I want to make sure that everybody knows everyone. And at the end of the day, a lot of these connections that are made, they continue after CPX. They're reaching out to each other just to continue that line of conversation. That's ideally how I help influence what my customers get out of CPX.
And I think it's so important, this the networking event. And, you know, I've been to a couple myself, and I understand the power of being able to connect people together. So I really appreciate, Vicki, that you take the time to help your customers make those connections. All right. It's all been really helpful insights and reasons why people should go, but I want to kind of switch to the fun stuff now. So Sarah, let's start with you. Last year was your first year attending. What was your favorite part about the event?
So I have to rack my brain about this one because there are so many, and I'm not just saying that because I'm on a panel. First thing that comes to mind is the keynote. Malcolm Gladwell was our keynote last year, and he really brought together the connectedness, that the kind of the theme of connectedness that the whole conference was meant to be about, and it kind of shined through the entire few days that we were there. And he really set the tone for let's get inspired. Let's get inspired by the technology, but let's also get inspired by each other and what we've all kind of, our journeys that we've been on with Anaplan and beyond, just, I mean, as an industry in general, kind of the opportunities that are out there. And then also, I have one more highlight. I think being exposed to kind of the possibilities, whether or not immediate or very much in the future, that Anaplan is looking to accomplish is just pretty neat. I do remember that there was this kind of like this video of thinking, you know, maybe 5 years when we have AI, machine learning, and all of these cool pieces of technology that we're going to be able to integrate with Anaplan, what Anaplan will be able to do for you. That was just super neat and super inspirational. And just starting out the conference in that way really kind of set the tone again, just for keeping an open mind and getting super excited about things that may seem a little bit uncomfortable at first because they are so different and they are so, I guess, like in the future kind of in a way. But really, I think like it was just the theme just kind of was so consistent across the board with the keynote and then with all the sessions and just all of the Anaplan folks and fellow customers that were presenting along the way as well.
Yeah, I think Frank introduced that that video last year during his keynote,
yes,
and it was
yeah.
it's really interesting because a lot of times you'll hear annual planners talk about the art of the possible, and we talk about that consistently, whether we're working on, you know, the platform itself or marketing campaigns or from a community perspective what we're doing with our community, and it really is about unlimited potential that we have, not only in the work that we do every day, how we help our customers, how we help you see the art of the possible. So that's a great connection, I think a great point too. All right, Vicki, you've attended 5 of these events. What are you most excited about this year?
Well, I've got a soft spot for CPX being back in home in San Francisco. That's going to be exciting. It's going to be at a great location with great views, but that's beside the point. Really, it's all about the content. We've had a really great year. We've had a lot of big names join the Anaplan family, and we've had a lot of big successes with our current customers. So I'm really excited to see them up on stage sharing what they've been able to accomplish with Anaplan. You know, I finger cross that some of my customers get to speak, and when they do, I'll be sitting in the room cheering them on. That's what I'm most excited about, just hearing our customers and what they've been able to do with Anaplan.
I would agree. I think that's one of the things that I also look forward to, is being able to just hear the stories, the transformational changes that our customers have used Anaplan to implement at their own company. So, yep, I'll be right there with you, Vicki. All right, Andrea, I'm sure you've heard the stories about previous Hub events. What is one secret or tidbit you're most excited to see come to life? And is there anything that you can secretly share with our viewers?
Oh, I don't want to give away too much. You know, I have the luxury of seeing things come to fruition from the back end. But I will leave you with 4 words: hands-on immersive experiences. Not only are we going to feature the Anaplan brand, but we'll also showcase new product innovations, features, and capabilities in very unique and creative ways. And that's all I'm going to give you. Of course, we'll highlight the ecosystem and customer stories to ensure that we're catering to the community of users and model builders, much like those listening to this recording or this call. But yeah, hands-on immersive experiences. We're excited about what we're bringing.
Fantastic. I think I know what you're talking about, and I'm super excited to see that come to life too. So Sarah, Vicki, Andrea, thank you so much for taking time to chat with us today. I'm really looking forward to connecting with everyone at CPX this year. And if you're joining us at CPX, be sure to stop by the community booth and say hello. Well, thank everyone and have a great day. Take care.
Thank you.